What's up, Katie? I hope everything's going good over there in Italy. You guys are pretty much halfway done over there probably by the time you get this. What's up, Sonia, by the way? We miss both you guys a lot. Katie, we really miss you. All the guys over here miss you. So that's why we made you this little video. Special thanks to Rob for editing the whole thing. He put it together with all his computer knowledge. So thanks, Rob. But hopefully everything's going good over there in Italy. You're having a lot of fun. We really miss you a lot. I miss you so much. And I hope you're having fun, but I hope you're not talking to too many guys who are there, because you gotta fucking kill those guys. Anyway, besides that, I hope you enjoy this video. We put a lot of hard work into it, sorta. But it was a lot of fun to make, and it just shows how much we really do miss you guys. And I can't wait to see you guys come back in December. Katie, I can't wait till I see you in December. It's gonna be great. So enjoy the video. I'll fucking kill those guys, I swear. Enjoy the video, and I can't wait to see you when you get back. Hopefully, you're looking forward to that too. I miss you. We all miss you. And hopefully this shows you guys how much we miss you. See you when you get back. Enjoy the video.
There are certain people you just keep coming back to. See, it's right in front.
Oh, hello, Katie and Sonia. Most Katie, I hear that your sister is very interested at the University of Marist College for next year, and I just want to present to you the many ways that is a good choice for your sister. Economically, I mean, it's phenomenal. I can't think of any statistically more sound reasons for her to come here. The people are very friendly. Dustin's here, I'm here. I think this is a chance for two great American families, the Bottles and the Whites, to finally be united in holy matrimony. Now, maybe I'm getting ahead of myself. She is only, what, 17? She was born in the 80s, right, Dustin?
Yeah, I think so.
If she was born in 1990, then that pushes my limit.
Yeah.
But if she's born in the 80s, Katie, then let's talk business here. I like her a lot. She likes me. And that's settled. It might be weird, yeah, having both you guys around here all the time, but from an economic standpoint, it makes sense for these two great American families to
How about academically?
Academically, I think it's a great decision.
Will Allie get, you know, most of her education?
She will.
Here
and I'll tell you why. Me and Dustin don't go out. We simply sit on our computers all day doing homework and studying. And that's a fact. That's why I look like this now. I haven't seen the sun in God knows how long, but we're going to wrap it up because Dustin's giving the signal. I miss you. Tell Allie I said what up. My family to yours. And Sonia, you look great. See ya.
Been away, haven't changed, had much to say.
But man, I still think them cats are crazy. They were asking if you were around, how you was, where you could be found. I told them you were living downtown, driving all the old men crazy.
Ha ha ha! Hello and welcome. We're here at Marist College driving range overlooking the Hudson. Take a nice look. You have two esteemed golfers. Rob Cannella on the right, 3-time PGA Tour championship winner. To your left, Dustin Allietti, 2-time winner at the Masters. We hope to see him in there again this year, representing Marist College. Wind hooking a little bit to the right today. If you look closely, it actually hit that boat you can see in the background.
I don't think Katie's dad could do that.
His nickname on the golf course is actually Happy Gilmore for his long drives.
Oh! Each. Mike, you want one?
I'd love one. Dustin.
Mike, step up.
All right, Katie. Watch close and learn.
What's up, professional golfer? Golf.
Mike Mouche and Rob have the advantage. They actually took a half a semester of golf here. So. Oh, oh.
The ball in the ground. Exactly where you want it to be. Interlock your fingers, of course. Great technique in golf.
You want to relax up there too, Mike. Not much pressure.
Ease the tension a little bit. And then, you're ready. We're doing another one.
John Capolino, what is your favorite movie?
That's a good one. My favorite movie would have to be The Brave, Little Toasted.
Are you sure that's the title?
No, I'm sure. I've seen it over 1,000 times.
And what is your favorite part about this movie?
Oh, well, you know, it's a spirited film about a toaster fighting for life.
That's great.
It battles everything. Toast.
Joe, what's your favorite movie?
Same thing.
John's favorite movie, as like me, is The Brave Little Toaster. The interesting part of the movie was the big robot at the end. A spirited machine with a large cervical. What he would do was extract the metaphysical. It's more of like a David versus Goliath theme.
Kaz, you can't think of any of this stuff on your own? John's got to help you with everything?
I would. You know, he has to bother me every 2 minutes. Besides the point. That needs help.
Well, Katie, my favorite movie is... Grease. What?
Save the Last Dance.
Grease, even though I haven't seen it yet. I think it's probably lovely. Alright.
Damn.
Caps, any last words?
I think I just thought of a new favorite movie. It's that movie. Oh, God, what is this? I'm drawing a blank.
Who's in it?
Julia Stiles. Ah, I said it already. Save the Last Dance. Ah, God. Why did I do this to myself?
Oh, man.
It's a good movie. It's a good movie.